random variables are either continuous or discrete. Continuous random variables. Example, weights of randomly selected boxes. Random variables are represented by uppercase letters. Let us represent these weights of randomly selected boxes by the uppercase letter X. The weights of the selected boxes can be 31.5 kilograms, 32.5 kilograms, 40 kilograms. Since the weights of the randomly selected boxes are represented by the uppercase letter X, these specific values should be represented by the lowercase letter X. So X is 31.5, X is 32.5, X is 40. These specific values are results of measurements. Let us write that. Specific values are results of measurements. Let's go to discrete. Discrete random variables. Example, let's say number of siblings of randomly selected students. Let us represent this number of siblings by the uppercase letter X. Let us say 20 students were randomly selected, and out of these 20, it was found out that one has no siblings, so zero. 8 of them, one sibling each. 6 of them, two siblings each. 5, 3 siblings each. These specific values should be represented by lowercase letter X. X equals 1, X equals 2, X equals 3. These specific values are results of counting. Let us write that. Specific values are results of counting. To distinguish them from the number of students, let us encircle the number of students. 1 student, 8 students, 6 students, 5 students, a total of 20 students. These values can be put in a table. X is 0, X is 1, X is 2, and X is 3. This table of values is called probability distribution table. This distribution, it is a list of the possible specific values of a discrete random variable together with the corresponding probabilities. How do we get the probabilities? 1 out of 20 or 1 divided by 20 is 0.05. That is the probability of 0. 1, this one, 8 of the students as on the one sibling each. So 8 over 20 or 8 out of 20. So 8 divided by 20 is 0.4. Yeah, 0.4. Then 6 out of 20, each of them has 2 siblings. So 6 out of 20, 6 divided by 20, 6 divided by 20 is 0.03, okay, 0.3, I mean. And then 5 out of 20, 5 over 20, 5 divided by 20 is, this is 1/4. So 0.25. So this is 0.25. So the probability of 0 is 0.05. The probability of 1 is 0.4. The probability of 2 is 0.3. The probability of 3 is 0.25. Each probability should be greater than or equal to 0, but less than or equal to 1. This means its probability is between 0 and 1 inclusive. Another thing to remember here, is that the total probabilities, or sigma p probability px, is equal to 1. Let's see if the sum is 1. probability of 0 plus probability of 1 plus probability of 2 plus probability of 3. The probability of 0 is 0.05. The probability of 1 is 0.4. The probability of 2 is 0.3. The probability of 3 is 0.25. If you add this together, the sum is 1.